Next section, theories of motivation. Researchers have developed many theories to explain motivation. Each individual theory tends to be rather limited in scope. However, by looking at the key ideas behind each theory, you can gain a better understanding of motivation. The forces motivation can be biological, social, emotional, cognitive in nature. Let's take a look at each one. Types of motivational theories following. First, instinct theory. Second, drive reduction theory. 3, arousal theory. 4, incentive theory. 5, cognitive theory. 6, goal-oriented theory. 7, Maslow's hierarchy need theory. First theory, instinct theory. The term instinct was first coined by William Wondert in 1870 to refer to any repeated behavior, the inherent tendencies by an organism to engage in certain unlearned pattern of behavior, or refers to as instincts. This theory is that use a complete emphasis on the biological approach to motivation. People born with programmed set of behavior essential to survival. Define instincts. Every organism is born with different biological traits and tendencies in order to help them survive. These are not learned or experienced behavior. Rather, pattern of behavior that occur naturally and are goal-directed. These patterns of behavior are referred to as instincts. And the theory suggested that instinct drives all behaviors. Example, when a newborn infant's cheek or lip is touched, it will turn into head towards it and making sucking motion with the mouth. This is known as rooting reflex, which assists in successful breastfeeding. Different theories of instincts. Many psychologists have defined instinct theory, which includes vital elements which explain a person's instinctive behavior. A. William McDougall was one of the first to write about instinct theory of motivation. According to him, instinct must be unlearned, uniform in expression, universal in species, and composed of perception, behavior, emotion. Based on three elements, he outlined 18 different instincts, such as maternal instincts, comfort, sex, hunger, curiosity, etc. B. Sigmund Freud, psychiatrist. Sigmund Freud suggested that human behavior was driven by two key factors: life instincts, encages in sex, eating, and other activities to be alive. Death instincts, encaging in aggressive behaviors like fights, stunts, not caring about survival. These aggressive activities help in releasing the instinctual energy. C. William James. William James is another psychologist to have studied about motivation, and he believed that our instinct is to survive. Important instinctive motivation factors in his theory. Fear, love, anger, shame, cleanliness, instinct theory of motivation, observation. Theory of motivation suggests that the key to our motivation is biological or genetic programming of our body. The general idea is that similar motivations occur on humans because of the similar biological programming shared by humans. Motivation to survive is the root of all motivations, and as we act or behave on other motivations emerged because of our core motivation, all our actions are considered as instincts. Critical evaluation. One of the major criticisms of the theory has been the fact that instincts are not universal. Another problem is that the levels of motivation can also be different. Simply labeling a behavior as instinct does not explain why certain behaviors appear in certain situations but not in others. However, this does not mean that psychologists have stopped their study on the subject matter. Second, drive reduction theory lacks some basic biological requirements. A drive is produces, example thirst due to lack of water in body. Motivation fulfills some need. It is based on the idea that we are driven by basic biological needs: food, water, shelter. Needs drive our behavior to seek homeostasis, balance, in our bodies. If we skip breakfast, we feel hungry. The hungry need drives us to find food to get rid of the hunger, thus bringing us back to a homeostatic state. Look at this picture. Drive reduction. Unbalanced equilibrium. Need for water. Drive example thirst. Try reduction behaviors, example drinking. Balance restored. These drives can either be primary biological needs like hunger, or secondary land need like money. However, drive reduction theory cannot explain all of our motivations. Sometimes we are motivated to perform behaviors that do not seem with any needs or drive, primary or secondary. 3. Arousal theory. Goal is maintenance of or increase in existence. Level of stimulation and activity determine arousal. The arousal theory states that we seek an optimum level of excitement or arousal. People with high optimum levels of arousal will be drawn to high excitement behaviors like bungee jumping, while the reset of us are satisfied with less existing and less risky activities. In general, most perform best with an optimum level of arousal, although this varies with different activities. We might perform well at an easy task with a high level of arousal, but the same high level of arousal would prevent us from performing well on a difficult task. Look at this graph. X-axis represent arousal, Y-axis represent performance quality. Low arousal, boredom, apathy. Optimum arousal, optimum performance. High anxiety, over arousal. Look at this, blue in color, difficult task, red in color, easy task. In general, we better perform best at moderate level of arousal. This concept is called the Yorks-Dodson law. The Yorks-Dodson law basically states that there is a middle or moderate level of arousal in which we all perform best. Fourth theory, incentive theory. Motivation in terms of nature of external stimuli. The incentive that direct and energize behavior. External incentives to push and pull behavior. Sometimes behavior is not push by a need, it is pull by a desire. Incentives are stimuli that we are drawn to due to learning. We learn to associate some stimuli with rewards and others with punishment, and we are motivated to seek the rewards. For example, you may learn that studying with friends is fun but does not produce the desired results around test time. So we are motivated to study alone to get the reward of a good test score. 5. Cognitive theory. Role of our thoughts, expectations, and understanding of the world. Two kinds of cognition. First, expectation. Second, understanding of value and goal. Promoting intrinsic motivation indicates that providing extrinsic reward. Role of our thought, expectations, and understanding of the world. The cognitive theory of motivation includes A. the goal setting theory, B. expectancy theory. A. Goal setting theory. Goal setting theory is based on the notion that individuals sometimes have a drive to reach a clearly defined end goal. Often this end state is a reward in itself. A goal's efficiency is affected by three features: proximity, difficulty, specificity. In 1960, Edward Locke put forward the goal-setting theory of motivation. This theory states that goal-setting is essentially linked to task performance. B. Expectancy theory. Expectancy theory was proposed by Victor H. Verum in 1964. This theory explained the behavior process in which an individual selects a behavior option over another and why, how this decision is made in relation to their goal. Motivation is equal to expectance into instrumentality into valency. M is equal to M into I into V. Look at this diagram. Expectance, effort. Can I hit my target if I work hard? Instrumentality, performance. Will hitting my target lead to rewards? Valence, reward. Do I find the rewards desirable? Expectancy is the belief that increased effort will lead to increased performance. If I work hard, then this will be better. Instrumentality. It is belief that if you perform well, that a valued outcome will be received. Balance. It is the importance that the individual places upon the expected outcome. 6. Goal-oriented theory. Goal orientation theory is a social cognitive theory of achievement motivation. Goal theory became a particularly important theoretical framework in the study of academic motivation in the late 1980s. These long-term goals helps direct behavior towards achievement and successes. Core goals is a long-term goal that drives much of what an individual does. Short-term goals refer to as proximal goals are more concrete and can be accomplished within a short-term period. Types of goal orientation, namely A. task-oriented goals, B. ego-oriented goals. Goal setting theory, developed by Edwin Locke. Properly and well managed task goals can be highly motivated. Motivational effects of task provide direction to people in their work, clarify performance expectation, provide foundation for behavioral self-management. 7. Maslow's hierarchy needs theory. Theory in psychology proposed by Abraham Maslow in 1943. His paper, A Theory of Human Motivation. In Psychological Review, need to form a hierarchy before higher order needs are met. Lower order needs must be fulfilled. Look at this hierarchy of needs: physiological needs, safety need, love, belonging, extreme, self-actualization. Before higher order needs are met, lower order needs must be fulfilled. Five-stage model. First, biological and physiological needs: air, food, drink, shelter, warmth, sex, sleep, maternity. Second, safety needs: protection from elements, security, order, law, stability, freedom from fear. Three, love and belongingness needs: friendship, intimacy, trust, acceptance, receiving and giving affection and love, affiliating, being part of a group, including family, friends, work. Four, extreme needs: achievement, mastery, independency, status, dominance, prestige, self-respect, respect from others. Five, self-actualization needs: realizing personal potential, self-fulfillment, seeking personal growth and peak experiences, etc. Motivational theories, its application in nursing. Nurses can apply motivational theory to assessment, planning, implementation and evaluation of patients. It helps the nurses identify unmet needs as they become healthcare needs and always the nurses to locate the patient on the health illness continuum and to incorporate the human dimensions and nursing models into meeting needs. Thank you. Have a nice day.